I'm gonna be a star. I'm gonna make it. I have nothing left to lose.
I'm Marcus Stewart, the fashion doctor.
Marcus is here. Very excited.
Your vintage team sucks ass.
Growing up, I was the youngest of three boys. I'm from New Orleans, Louisiana. And at the gate, I was the underdog. My mom didn't want to have any other kids, and here comes Marcus. Modeling was my sport. It was the only thing I was better at than my brothers, so I stuck with it. My introduction to fashion came through modeling. I was a model as a kid. My mom was a model in the late 70s. So I like to think that I got it very honestly. My most coveted modeling moment would have to be being photographed by the legendary Antoine Verglas. Hurricane Katrina was a tragedy. It devastated my community, but also was a blessing because I ended up moving across the country at age 16, alone, without my parents, to fulfill my dreams of modeling and working in the fashion industry.
And that's just the half of it. Yeah, you stop the half.
I had way too much personality. I had so many opinions and just way too much to say. So I knew that I had to step from in front of the camera and start creating things. I applied to college at FIDM. I was accepted, and that's when my fashion career started. When I started working for Dolce & Gabbana, I was 17, the youngest person they had ever hired. At 18, I wanted more. I was hired by Sacred Blue Denim in the middle of the huge denim craze as their international sales rep. I thought I had it all. It was LA Fashion Week in 2007. Where my life would change forever. I met Andre Leontali, who then became my mentor for the next 3 years. Right away, I quit my corporate lucrative job and became an intern for Lisa Love at Vogue magazine. Because of the gates that Andre Leontali opened for me, I then became a stylist assistant for Vogue, Men's Vogue, Teen Vogue, GQ magazine, Lucky magazine, and Vanity Fair Italia. After working in the magazine industry for a year and a half, I moved to New York City to take more modeling jobs. Unknowingly, that's where my life as a style expert would really take off. I was approached by the owners of Decades Boutique, which is based out of Los Angeles, to help with their East Coast business.
Marcus is here. Very excited. Marcus is my New York liaison.
I became the East Coast buyer and national trunk show coordinator. Over the next 3.5 years, I traveled all around the world, shopping for and styling socialites. Nothing could prepare me for what would happen next. Worldwide recognition and fame. Bravo TV came calling to chronicle the days of the Dukes of Melrose, and we answered.
Marcus is here.
Marcus, good morning.
Good to see you.
Welcome to sort of sunny LA.
I know.
He was one of the first to really use the military look in fashion.
Oh. Before, exactly.
Marcus, you're going back to New York with him.
I'm excited.
Are you okay flying business instead of first?
I'm okay with that. I think I could make that sacrifice.
Dude, it's pretty cool. I feel comfortable in it.
And it's Lanvin Couture. Throws your arms off.
This one is actually in good condition.
The color's great.
500, you said?
Hold on, 550.
And this is how much, 450?
And that I told you, 450.
I think we're okay.
So wait, 1350 plus the 22. Can I use your calculator?
Cameron is my boss. It's not my job to monitor his spending, but I do hope that he stays under budget because I don't want to have to deal with the raft of crystals.
And 88 cents.
10 pairs.
Oh yeah, these are amazing.
Good job.
Yeah.
For us, two young, good-looking, hard-working guys.
Just one shot, me and her.
Mom.
Oh God, here it goes.
All right, just that's enough.
Have we been checking messages here?
Oh, I don't know how to check messages.
You have 99.
99 messages.
What is going on?
Marcus, will you listen to all these messages? It's crazy.
Hey, Cameron. Which button did you press to check the messages? I've never been taught how to check a message.
You're gonna be here for like the rest of your life.
I don't know, how much was it?
1,300 euro.
So it was about $2,000?
Yeah, I just thought it was like so crazy.
You,
this would look cool on you.
I would wear
you
this.
Should wear this to church.
I would wear it on Sunday.
So Marcus is gonna be handling logistics. Do you wanna talk us first about the overall idea of what's gonna be happening at the event?
Yeah, we decided to go with a different concept this time around. It's gonna be boutiques within boutiques. So you're gonna have a Prada Schiaparelli feel, then you come over to the vintage, but it's still open flow.
Right, I like that.
Hey, Marcus.
Hey, new Prada?
I know you're packing up right now, but I'll get it all done before you're...
In like 30 minutes?
30 minutes, okay.
Good afternoon, Marcus. 2 o'clock, the driver will be here. Okay, thank you so much.
Jared, you live for this stuff.
Seriously, will you do something before you lift
you
that?
Gotta squat. Yeah. You have, seriously, you have to squat like that and then take it up.
Let's see.
Like that and then go up. No, because you're gonna have your back go out.
I don't pack up for New York.
Oh, got it. Sorry.
This crystals, the Chanel thing, we'll do like, after the jewelry, we'll do like a little section right here. One box is still missing. It's like a $500,000 box, basically.
It's missing?
Jared sent it out ground instead of express. That's all I'm saying.
You know, it was Marcus's responsibility as the coordinator for this event. He should make sure that he's getting all that information from everybody.
Well, let's bring him over. Marcus.
No, I agree. It's like this is a thing.
He wants to talk to you about Jared's box.
No, but this is a thing that, like, for future events, if you don't have tracking information, you have to ask for it.
In Marcus' defense, he didn't even know a box didn't go.
This is the problem. Your vintage team sucks ass. 32 boxes left LA, 32 boxes arrived. I did my part in terms of the transit.
Okay. I don't let staff talk back to me, and I'm not going to let Marcus not be a responsible young man. You keep making excuses about everybody else.
I'm gonna make
it
excuses.
Is your
I'm just
job
saying the
to
truth.
Make sure they get
Cameron,
the stuff done.
I'm very,
and if they don't,
I'm very
Marcus,
uptight
they're
about
not,
everything. I don't Marcus, ever complain. Have you ever heard me complain?
Crystals, was I working nonstop?
He was working nonstop.
Okay. Marcus.
Because of Bravo TV, I began to get press from all over the world. Everyone wanted to know, who is that tall, good-looking brown guy? And I answered, The Fashion Doc.
Marcus Stewart, The Fashion Doctor.
As The Fashion Doctor.
Fashion Doctor, Marcus Stewart is reality TV star and The Fashion Doctor. Fashion Doctor, Marcus Stewart. The Fashion Doctor is here. Marcus Stewart is here with us. The Fashion Doctor, Marcus Stewart. You take this very seriously. You diagnose the fashion problems. And you give a prescription of how to remedy that, right?
Exactly. Fashion is a serious thing, and when looking
glad
for
you're with us to kind of bring some of the fall runway trends to real life, right?
Yes, yes.
Get an updated look, maybe to the power suit.
Exactly. You don't, especially for women, you don't want to lose your feminine touch. This is the difference between a woman and a man. Yes.
He is here this morning, and you're going to help us get ready for the holidays.
That's right. It's here, so it's time to know how to get your get up going.
Definitely. Okay, so just give us some general overviews. What are we doing this holiday season?
Well, I think it's important to pay attention to little black dresses with sequins, of course.
Okay.
That's something that you can get out of your closet already. Red, because that's a festive color.
Mm.
And metallics. Let's glam it up a bit. And this little play on a necklace is great here. It's like little bugle beads, which is a great way to have sequins. You know what? This is an amazing red Marc Jacobs dress. But this has texture and it's a great A-line silhouette. This looks great on every age range, from a 20-year-old to a 55-year-old woman. This is perfect. I mean, this is should be in every woman's closet, regardless of where you live. You want to be comfortable. You still want to be a lady and have the feminine.
From modeling to life as a style expert, and now as a TV personality, all before the age of 25. This is only the beginning, so stay tuned because the best is yet to come. Signing off, this is Marcus Stewart, the Fashion Doctor, and remember, there's no style sickness too great that the Fashion Doctor cannot heal.